No. People are like carrier bags. Sometimes they are. Some, you can throw anything at them and they're all right. Others, they're ready to collapse as soon as you put anything in. You know, my Charlie. Oh, he was a first-rate Essien. Double-stitched round the edges. You know, if Harrods had sold Essien, he'd have had the logo woven in gold. But my mum, she was one of your freebies, all thin and flimsy, ready to collapse as soon as you put anything in it.
Mary, that cough's getting a lot worse. How time you?
No, it's a bit better than now today. I rubbed some Vic on my chest last night.
Have you performed yet today?
No. The first batch will be when the matinee comes out. About 10 minutes, I'd say. I gave myself a bit longer to get here today. I ain't as fast as I used to be.
I know, Mary, but you could give it a miss for once.
I ain't missed a day in 10 years. I'm not going to let a little cold get in the way.
Now, Mary, you know it's more than a little cold. You'd need to take care of yourself. Why don't you think about the shelter for a couple of nights?
Oh, will you stop fussing, for Christ's sake? I can't stand fussing.
Okay, I'm sorry, but listen here, I got you a prezi. Orange one, nice and strong. You go well with your sister.
Oh, right. I ain't seen an orange one before. That's good and big. That'll take a lot of stuff, thanks, girl.
You still got the blue one, then?
Oh, yeah. There it is. Got all my important things in.
Oh, picture of Charlie, maybe?
No, I don't need a picture. Got him up here. I can see him any time I like.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, okay, I'll be right there. Where is it? Okay. Mary, I've got to go. Bit of trouble under the bridge. I'll see you later.
Yeah, you take care, girl. There's a lot of nasty characters about. And we'll have a coffee break later. I want to hear how you're managing that arse of a sergeant. Strong Italian. Two sugars. That's PC Sue Barker. She's over from Ireland. She's all right, though, for a copper. She's definitely not a flimsy. But she needs a bit of toughening up if she's going to get long life standard. You know, you learn a lot about people when you're on the road. And carrier bags. Got all sorts here. 10p and 50p long lifers. Flimsies for me rubbish. And these special ones. This is my favourite, the Ladybird one. Sue gave me that. Oh, hang on. That's the matinee coming out. Come on. Charles Rowland to the Dark Tower came by Robert Browning. My first thoughts were, he lied in every word, that hoary cripple with the malicious eye, askance to watch the workings of his lie on mine.
Well, she's a killer. You need to keep that in mind. Yes, I know she may be old, but she is a calculating bitch and a killer. The manuscript will be in the trolley. There's a pile of old carrier bags, colour-coded, would you believe? It will be in one of those. I need you to get alongside her, gain her trust. I don't care how, just use your charm. I need you to get alongside her now, quickly. No violence. Not yet.
And there they stood, ranged upon the hillside, set to view the last of me. a living frame for one more picture. And through a sheet of flame I saw them, and I knew them all. Yet, dauntless, the slug horn to my lips I set and blew. Child Roland to the dark tower came. For your further education, there's a stall over there with a few books with the poem in it. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you, madam. Thank you, sir. Have a nice day. Yes, thank you, and you too, yes. It gets longer every bleeding time. Oh, didn't think I was going to get to the end today. Oh, are you, Charlie? Were you listening today?
Aren't I always?
Right, let's have the review then.
I think you just give that last bit a bit more punch, my love.
What do you expect? It's 34 bleeding verses long. I ain't got the breath for it no more. I don't think I can do two a day.
Did I ever mention what cigarettes will do?
Did you ever? I stopped though, didn't I?
About 30 years too late.
Right. So it's Mr. Negativity, is it? Well, you can bugger off then. I don't need you around. You can come back when you've got something nice to say.
I'm so sorry.
What do you think? Get off.
Oh, no, please let me off.
No, get your paws off, you bleeding tea leaf. This is master. Get off.
I'm so awfully sorry. I didn't see you there.
I've seen you. Watching me, just waiting to get your hands on me stuff.
Oh, please. I mean, I have seen you before. I mean, I usually jog at the bank every morning. I usually see you asleep on your bench, but no, not watching you.
That's like I said, spying on me. I ain't always asleep, you know. So, sod off, I don't need you around.
Okay, here, let me push
no,
it.
No, I'm all right, leave it alone.
You sure you need help?
No, what are you after? Well, you ain't getting any anyway, because it's not on offer no more.
What are you talking about? Oh. No.
You don't look as if you ever had none. I could have given you a good seeing to once.
I'm sure it would have been bad. Have you seen, you don't look well. Have you seen the doctor?
You've mucked up me filings since anyway. It's none of your fucking business.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It looks like a great system. Very neat for a,
What? For a tramp? Well, do you know what? I got a mate over in Waterloo Station. Get a wash and brush up most days. I don't smell bad, see? So, you go around making assumptions.
Of course not. sorry. Well, nice little radio. Small, neat, handy. you can relax. I'm not going to steal it.
Oh, Lord, see you try. See this? One blow of this and you'd have half the South Bank down on top of you. I'm respected round here, you know, so don't you forget it.
Oh, yes, of course. Sorry.
Afternoon play.
Oh, pardon?
It's what I listens to, mostly. I do listen to some other stuff, but it's not really worth the batteries. And that play, well, the play's usually worth a listen to.
Oh, you should get a charger. It's cheaper in the long run. Oh, yeah, yes, of course. How stupid of me. Yes. Oh, well, I could buy you a set of batteries and keep them charged up for you if you like.
Why?
Why not?
Why would you do that?
I have no reason.
Definitely after something. Hmm. You know? You could bugger off. My mother told me not to talk to strange men.
Oh, well, I'm James. You're Mary, aren't you? I've heard a policewoman call you that.
And did she tell you what colour me knickers were and all? Sod off!
Everything okay, Mary?
Where were you when this... I was being knocked down by this dangerous criminal.
Oh, no, it wasn't like that at all, no.
Oh, put your cuffs on him, Mary. He's been assaulting my ears.
No, please, sorry, I didn't mean it like that.
No, leave off, I'm all right.
You're not all right, Mary.
Oh, you need to get that seen to.
Oh, she's a stubborn old. That's why I keep telling her, oh, she's impossible.
Oh, well, sounds like you look after her.
Oh, when she lets me. I think she keeps more of an eye on me. So what did you do to upset the bard at the South Bank?
Got in the way of her trolley.
Oh, that trolley's a lethal weapon in Mary's hands.
Tell me about it. I just wish that there was something I could do.
Oh,
you
know? I know. Look, when you two have finished poking your noses in, I want a bit of peace and quiet. Just sod off.
I'll get you a coffee later, Mary.
Yeah, don't forget the sugar.
Nice to meet you, Mary.
Yeah, I'm sure. Take him away, Sue. My first thoughts were, he lied in every word. That's the beginning of the poem. But you know, I think that Robert Browning knew a thing or two. Always assume that people are lying and never trust nobody.
So when did my beautiful muse become so cynical?
Oh, blimey, Charlie. Give me heart failure creeping up on me like that. I hope you're in a better frame of mind.
You're in charge of my mind, my love.
Oh, well, you can give me shoulders and massage then.
Mind if I sit here?
Bloody hell, girl. You're going to catch your death in that top if you don't freeze your tits off first.
Never used to bother you.
Might have always had a bit more flesh on you than that one.
Lovely, I'm sure you.
Never had to hang around places like this, neither.
It's not a bad place for picking up punters. I was listening to you back there. How do you remember all that?
I used to perform it for a punter, didn't I, Charlie?
Who's Charlie?
In what's giving me back a massage.
Oh, right.
I ain't seen you round here before.
Change me patch. What did you mean about performing? And you were like me on the game then, were you?
No, I was never like you. I never had to hang around places like this, flashing me tits and freezing me arse off. I belonged to a classy place where people had to book us, you know, but I was never out of work. And I never had to stick stuff in my arms either.
Oi, let go!
Expensive habit, that, my girl. You gave that up, you probably wouldn't have to parade around this place.
I am gonna stop. I am. I started a programme.
Yeah? And do you think you'll stick to it? Do you think you've got what it takes? I think you're a bit of a flimsy.
A what?
Carry your bag. The sorts what split.
I said before, what did you mean about performing?
Well, you see, there was this posh guy I used to go to in this big house full of books and antique stuff. I had to dress up all prim and proper and glasses and stuff. And then I had to walk around the room bending over and climb up the ladder to look at the books. Get a picture?
Blimey. Is that all? You ought to hear what the pervs ask for now.
You're just finding out that people are crap, are you? Well, I used to think all punters were the same till Charlie came along. But he weren't no perv. He just liked a bit of spice. Over the moon he was when he found out I knew this poem. I learned it at school, see? And so he got me to do all the other stuff while I was saying the poem. He liked to time it so that we hit the spot, so to speak. Just at the end of the last line, Child Roland to the Dark Tower came. Okay? No? never mind.
So, how long were you on the line then?
Oh, never you mind. I got out with help from my friend, didn't I, Charlie?
Ollie. My name's Ollie. You're Mary, aren't you?
Yeah, I think you need to get out of this game as quick as you can.
Why are you so bloody awkward?
Well, I just think you need to get out as quick as you can.
All right. I best sod off then,
yeah? Yeah, I think you better. And just think about stopping while you can. Oh, bugger off. What's that supposed to mean?
Making me sound like...
What, like a punter?
Used to be softer too.
Well, what is there to be soft about? You cleared off. Took all me soft with you. Left me with your sodding poem. What good's that?
Keeping it safe then?
Of course I am. Here. In the bag with the ladybird.
You were my ladybird.
I was never no lady, Charlie.
Thank God.
But here it is. Safe. What'd you take me for?
Bank would be safer.
Oh, don't start. Don't go on about it, because I ain't going to sell it. Never. Yeah, I know what you said. But if I sold it, I wouldn't have anything left of you, would I, Charlie? Oh, no, it's no good trying to make me change my mind. You know, Charlie loved that manuscript. He says, one day, Mary, when I'm better, we will sell it and cruise around the world. I had to say it to him. Every night at the end, took his mind off the pain. But he'd say, look, look, Mary, here it is. Robert B's actual writing. It says, to my darling Lizzie, my muse, my friend, my wife, from your loving husband, Robert. I used to have to say that to him and all, because he loved it so much. And then he'd say, to my darling Mary, my muse, my friend, my wife. Oh no, I ain't your wife, I'd say. Not for want of trying, he said. But he'd never have sold it. And neither will I. Imagine having a poem written for you. Well, it is a tad on the morbid side. You think that Robert B. could have thought of something more cheerful for his Lizzie. But you know, people are funny, aren't they? Like carrier bags. You think of that James. You think he's all first class, long life. Then you discover that it all hasn't been stitched right and the seams falling apart. Oh! And then, I reckon that, Holly.
Ah, it's me, back again. Morning. I bought the batteries and I thought you might like a copy. Here you go.
sugar?
Yes, I have packets here. There's one, and there's the other.
Spoon.
Oh, yes, I have a plastic one right here. So, rechargeable batteries.
Why the hell do you think I'm going to charge them?
See, I thought of that. I got you two lots, so I can keep them charged up for you if you like, and I can swap them around.
Why would you do that?
No reason.
What are you after?
Coffee or rice?
Yeah. Not as good as the Italian, but it will do.
Listen, don't bite my head off, but I recently got a new one and I thought you could have my old one. It's digital. That means...
Oh, I know what it means. Expensive is what it means.
Well, it's got a lot more channels. You can listen to all the old songs from the 60s and all your old shows if you like.
Well, you don't often make assumptions, do you? You see an old woman and you think she knows me. What makes you think I want to listen to all that rubbish?
Yes, of course. Sorry.
Please, thank you now.
No, I ain't going to say thank you. He's after something, Charlie, I'm telling you.
For one, he's a nice young man.
All right, come on. You can put the channels in for me.
Oh, yes, right. Of course.
Wonder why your listening habits then?
Oh, I might fancy a change now and again.
And there's a decent pair of headphones that go with us as well. Now they go right into...
I can see where they go. I ain't blind. Oh, what is this now? Are you some wrinkling Jiminy Cricket?
Sorry?
What? I ain't talking to you.
No.
I'm talking to Charlie.
Who?
Oh, never mind.
Yes, I was actually just about to come. I nearly have a sorter, so I just need a bit more time. Maybe till the end of the month, and... Oh, no, please, give me a break here. I need 2 weeks. Right, of course. business partner, say? That was a...
I ain't
just...
interested. It's your business. We're not all nosy gits.
Right, of course. Well, I best be off. Business calls, as you know.
Am I stopping you? I don't think so.
Right, of course. Well, pop my jersey with the batteries.
That young man was in trouble.
That's bleeding obvious. Drugs, I reckon. Getting to know the type, you know? But, I don't know. Come and let's have a bit of this. I need to work out how to work this contraption. Oh, bollocks! Don't I know it? She drove me mad.
What a day that was.
I can't keep up with you, Charlie. Oh, blimey, Meg.
I never experienced this before. Would we go back to the, what's it called? Caterpillar after lunch?
Oh, no, no. Not if you don't want me throwing up all afternoon. I tell you what, I'll buy you fish and chips in a page. Bet you never experienced that before.
In a bay? How do I eat them?
With your fingers, of course. Oh, we need to do a lot of catching up on you, you know. I think I'll take you to Battersea next week. The big timber will brown your pants for you.
Mary, Marilyn.
Oh, don't start with the stupid.
I won't be around much longer.
Well, don't talk about the morbid, neither.
Mary, I'm 20 years older than you.
Exactly. So I ain't marrying you. I'm not having that Edward and a skinny bit of a wife up fucking it back from down under, complaining that I'm a gold digger.
I don't give a damn.
I can just hear her now. Oh, marrying someone twice her age. We all know what she's after. Well, I'd give her a belt. You know, we're comfortable, aren't we? Why can't you just let me go on cooking and bonking for you? You gave me loads already.
I just want you to be all right when I'm gone.
Oh, look, we're comfortable. There's no point complicating matters. You just keep on teaching me about the old stuff, and I'll go on creating new recipes in the kitchen and in bed. Yes. I've got one or two things you ain't experienced yet, my love.
Let's not wait. Let's share all the time we can before it's too late. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be.
I'd like a decent coffee for a change.
Oh, you're up early. No pumpers last night.
Night off. Here you go. Two sugars.
Thanks. Strong Italian.
Yeah, of course. Boy, guess what I saw in the dentist yesterday on the crappy pile of magazines?
Go on, remind me.
You on the front page of some posh Sunday Meg, barred up the South Bank, it called you. Here, look, I nicked it for you.
Oh, yeah. Blimey. They don't clear out their magazines very often, do they?
Barred up the South Bank, eh?
Stupid title, I told that reporter. I weren't, strictly speaking, a bard, because I didn't write it. But, you know, he thought it was a snappy title. It's all about giving them what they want, Mary, he said. Stupid know-it-all, I was doing that already.
Yeah, let me read it. Let's see what it says. Mary, the bard of the South Bank. This 60-year-old draws the crowds wherever she recites Browning's epic poem, whether it's outside West End theatres or on the South Bank. She stops sightseers and theatre-goers in her tracks. With her rich London voice, rolls out the lines. You don't do West End now, though, Mary, do you?
No. That was, what, 10 years ago? I had more stamina then. Hadn't been on the road very long. But you know, I had a good run. Punters always loved it. Especially the Yanks. They say, oh, Elma, come and listen to this little old lady saying this old poem. And then they'd always be good for a 20. And then they'd go off and buy books on Mick's store. So he was happy, so he gave me 10%.
All right. And was Charlie around then?
No, he wasn't. So shut up with the nosy.
Didn't the paper pay you?
Of course they paid me. Asked for cash, didn't I? Had a nice weekend at the Hilton.
You at the Hilton. They'd never let you in, Mary.
Who
who's staying at the Hilton?
Mary says she stayed at the Hilton. Cash.
They never let you stay at the Hilton, Mary.
No, well, just shut up with the sarcasm, will you? I got a wash and brush up from me mate. Bought some posh togs in Oxfam. Good as anyone.
They'd never let you in, Mary. You're having me on.
Where would you get cash, Mary?
We got it from this.
What's that?
Look.
God, Mary, you never said you were famous.
Says she stayed at the Hilton. Cash.
Never.
What is this? A double act? Do you know, it just shows how much you know, doesn't it? Frightfully sorry about the cash. Just up at town from the estate. Gambled a bit too much last night. Had to hock the diamonds. And then you make sure you give them a generous tip, like.
Mary, I never know when to believe your stories. Actually, tried to convince me once she had a rare manuscript.
A manuscript? What was that there, Mary?
Nothing. You keep your noses out. Oh, thank God, here's Charlie. He'll talk some sense.
Morning, my muse.
Where the hell did you get to? You've not been around for the last 2 weeks. Now, you two, I need to catch up with Charlie, so I just bugger off.
Mary, the Sally Army have a bed in their hostel. I think you should consider it.
No, I've seen you two talking. It's enough from you trying to interfere in people's lives. Well, I ain't going nowhere. Go on, sod off. Where have you been?
You were busy with your new friends.
But it's you I need, Charlie. Every day. Don't you see?
I've been looking after you.
Oh, they're getting on me tits, Charlie. He's here every 3 days with his batteries and his soddy soup. She's here nearly every night. Thinks I'm the original tart with an R. Tells me all her troubles. She's having a bad time with her pimp. Oh, I'd give him a good seeing to it. I had a bit more energy. But I don't need it, Charlie. I just need some peace and quiet.
Mary, Mary,
sorry, song.
Not waiting.
Anybody interfering, but you won't let me, Charlie. You won't let me. Oh. Don't want anyone messing around with me. Don't you see that, Charlie? Charlie? Charlie's favourites.
And did he sing it to you?
No. He played it to me. First time he asked me to marry him. Kersal, Southend-on-Sea. I took him there for his 70th birthday. When I found out he'd never been to a funfair. Can't remember how many times he rode that Big Dipper.
Did you marry him?
No, not in a marrying kind. Never stopped him asking, though. Every year on his birthday for 20 bleeding years. Daft sod. Do you know, he even carved an art on one of the doors in the Tunnel of Love. Charlie, Arrow, Mary. But I couldn't say it back to him, though.
Oh, hi, Mary. I was just... Oh, it's getting worse, Mary. I was just speaking to my doctor. He thinks you should be in hospital.
Ollie, James, James, Ollie. I ain't going near no hospital, didn't I tell you? Don't stop, don't interfere.
Oh, well, we think it's best.
No, don't go around talking about me.
Oh, okay, all right then. Well, supper then. At least come to the cafe with me and get something hot in you. You do a nice steak and kidney, right?
I don't feel like moving. Take Ollie. Just bring me some of their soup.
Oh, Holly, is it? Care for a bite to eat?
Don't mind if I do.
Let's have a bit of classical. Oh, shit. Oh, Charlie. I'm going to do eggs benedict with smoked salmon for breakfast tree. How's that sound?
Not feeling too hungry this morning, my love.
Oh, come on. You've got to eat something. Bit of porridge.
In a minute, maybe. Come and sit. Marry me, Mary.
Oh, don't start. Oh, that's stupid.
I haven't got long, Mary.
No, don't go on being morbid either. No, no. Look, and I found this article on berries.
I can barely eat, Mary. I just want to.
No, don't whip out on me now. There's this place in America.
Come on, Mary. We've done it all. You've given me 20 amazing years and more happiness than I could. I love you more than...
No, don't start with the soppy. And I am going to cry because... There's nothing to cry about. You're going to be fine.
Mary, come on. Please shut up and listen. The will I've given, the will has been done by Peter. He's been a good solicitor, even if he doesn't approve.
He never did. I reckon it was because he wasn't getting any.
Come on, Mary. I've left everything to my grandson. I know my son will try to overturn the will, and I've left half the house to you, and all the house and half of mine.
Oh, look, I don't want anything. I just want you.
Mary, marry me.
No, don't stop.
And you'll be all right, please.
No. Don't start with the stupid again.
Morphine when it gets worse.
Oh.
Please, Mary. I have a carrot here and a key. Use the key to the safe deposited box with that firm, with this firm, and here's their carrot. Now, child, Roland is safe. Even if Edward tries to.
Uh-oh. What is there I can do to help?
Come on, Mary. You've got to listen to the rest. No hospice. Just you and me here.
Yeah, well, I'll promise, but things ain't gonna happen.
Please, Mary, promise me that I can stay here.
I will promise you. I promise you, you daft bugger.
Mary,
oh, don't start, you daft bugger.
Who do you think, Mary?
Sergeant Patty Paws. Well, I think you need to give him a quick, swift kick in the balls.
It's not that simple, Mary. You don't understand.
Well, it's not that hard. Just tell the arsehole to keep his wandering hands to himself. Oh, you report him. There's laws now.
If I do that, Mary, I'm out. I'm not on the team. I'm out on my own.
Bloody men.
But it's not just the men, Mary. Some of the women too. What do you expect? It's just a bit of fun. Just a bit of crack. They laugh themselves. But they're just desperate to fit in.
You should start an agony aunt page. As good as this.
Oh, I didn't bleed and choose it, Charlie. I don't need it. I just want a bit of peace.
Hello, Charlie. How are you?
Sue?
Yes, Mary.
I do know he's not really here.
I know you know, Mary.
It's just when my head's all full and bursting with thoughts, he helps me put some order on it.
Like your bags?
Yeah, I ain't balmy, Mary.
I know, Mary, you're not sure. Look, I talked to the cat. Who might say who's balmy?
Oh.
Okay, yeah, I'm right there. Mary, gotta go. All right, see you later.
Let's have a bit of classical before we turn in.
James, she's a nice old girl. I think you're wrong about her.
Oh, well, you're getting paid, aren't you?
Yeah, but...
Right. So I decide her love. And don't let her fool you. She's good at that.
All she said was that she used to recite it for a Amanda. You don't even know she's got the manuscript. You don't even know that he was your grandfather.
Oh, she's got it on, right? It's never come up on the Marcus. I would have known it if it had. Grandfather was Charles, and her Panta was Charlie. She was the one that was with him.
But you should hear her talk about him, James. She loved him. She really loved him.
Oh, took the stupid bastard for a bride. Still, didn't do her much good. They drew out the will when she was proved guilty. 15 years, less than she deserved, but still, out in 10.
Like, what did she do with the manuscript in prison then, James? I think you're wrong about her!
Well, fortunately you're not paid to think. Now go and see her tonight. Wait until she is fast asleep and go through that trolley. I saw something with a ladybird on it.
No, I ain't gonna do it, James. You can keep your money!
Oh, you'll do it,
you're off me!
Yes? What? No, please. Just a bit more time. I'm nearly there. Oh, Christ.
What are you going to do now?
Oh, never you mind. This is all your fault in the first place. If you've just done what you're told, that old bitch deserves whatever she gets.
Stones. in your pocket and jump. It's supposed to be easy. But he always stops me.
Mary.
See what I mean? He always stops me.
You are not your mother, Mary. Don't ever forget that.
I know. But I think you're punishing me, Charlie. I just need to know that I did it right. You won't tell me. Why won't you say? You asked me. Help me, Mary, you said. And I need to know that you did it right. It's a burden to me. Oh, Charlie.
Mary, I brought some soup.
Oh, blimey. You're creeping up on me like that. You nearly gave me heart failure. You nearly had me in the river.
Oh, well, sorry. I just brought you some stuff from the cafe.
Arrest him for careless walking.
I'm going off duty, Mary. I just came in to check on you.
Oh, I just brought her some soup. Will you tell her she has to drink it?
Mary, I see you're being well looked after. Do as he says. It'll do you good. I'm off for a long weekend, so I'll see you next week. Think about the hostel for a couple of nights. You try and talk some sense into her, will you, please?
Look, I'll drink the sodding soup if you just give me some peace.
Oh, I know that tone. I'm off. I'll say good night to both of you.
Good night.
Well, how did you get on with Ollie? Did she sort you out?
yes, she's certainly lovely. Oh, I bought the batteries, Mary. Why don't I go ahead and change them all?
No, there's more trouble. No, get out.
No, it's okay, I'll just change them over.
No, you take too many liberties.
But okay, how about I just go ahead and just sit quietly and...
No, I ain't giving you a blowjob. I ain't got a breath no more.
Okay, alright. I'll just go.
Oh. You know, he looks quite like you, Charlie. He's got your nose in your mouth, but I knew him straight away. And I know he's after something, and I think I know what it is. But I need you to tell me, Charlie, did I do it right? It stuck in my head and it hurts. But I thought being banged up would help. Like saying three long Hail Marys. But it's just there, stuck in my head all the time. It just hurts. You all right, Mary? What's it to you? I gotta go to work, but am I stopping you? Don't think so.
I don't know how to say this. It's just...
Well, spitting it out usually helps.
It's James, Mary.
You don't know him well, do you?
I didn't know you back then, all right?
No. Well, working for him, are you? Getting round the old granny?
Mary, you got to be careful with him. He ain't all that he appears to be.
Oh, I know what he's after. Don't you worry. I can handle it.
Couldn't you go into a shelter just for tonight? Be safer just for tonight?
No, it's all right, girl. Don't you go fretting.
Right. You don't know him, Mary. When he's desperate, it makes him really...
Look, oh, I know what I'm doing. Don't you worry. It'll all turn out fine.
All right. Be careful, Mary. I'll pop back later, okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bring me a cup of something, okay. Will you?
Is Charlie... Give my love to Charlie, is he?
He's right here.
Okay.
He won't go wandering about anymore.
You look after yourself, Mary, okay? Be careful. See you later.
Yeah. You know, I used to think she was a bit of a flimsy. But I think she's getting there. She's getting to steadier things. She just needs a bit of a leg up and she'll be all right.
Forgot to leave you your nightcap, Mary. I'm sorry for intruding earlier on. I brought a flask. Forgive me.
Maybe. What's in it? Brandy?
Oh, just a slug.
Will it help me sleep?
Yep, like a baby. Go on, Mary. Drink up while it's still warm.
Well, if at his council, I should turn aside into that ominous tract, which all agreed hides the dark tower. Yet, acquiescingly, I did turn as he pointed, neither pride nor hope, rekindling at the end, descried as much as gladness that some end might be.
What? Why are you... It's just your poem. I just haven't heard you do that for quite a while.
No. I can't do it no more, James. I think it's time to stop, don't you, James?
Yes. Yes, probably. Go on, Mary, drink up.
Taste the brandy. Better answer that. It might be important.
Hello? Yes. I have it all sorted. Yeah, see you soon. See you in 20. Yes. I'd best be off, Mary. Good night. I'll see you tomorrow.
Looks a lot like you, Charlie. Got your nose and your mouth, but not your eyes. But I don't want him to have it. It could go to the bad, and I don't want that. I want it to do some good. You know, you did look a lot like you. Your nose and your mouth, but not your lovely eyes. When you looked at me with those eyes, I knew I was being loved. But I couldn't say it back, you old bugger. Hold me tight, Charlie.
I hear the sound of distant drums far away, far away.
What are you doing? Put that down!
Will you shut up, you stupid bitch?
I scream! I'm warning you, James!
Oh, wait, just shut up! Shut up!
You ain't caught! You were the fighting of the sigh of blood. What have you done? Mary. What have you done to her?
I've nothing. I just gave her a nightcap. That's all.
What was in it?
Oh, brandy. Just brandy. That's it. That was it.
So you could have stole her head in.
Oh, well, what choice did I have? If I don't get the money to send her, I'll stove my head in.
I've left a message for Sue, so you best sort off! Mary! Oh, wake up, Mary! It looks like she's obliged you by dying anyways!
Oh, well, stop stroking her head, you stupid cow, and help me look. Oh, where is it? Oh, where is it? Where is it? Where did you leave it? Where is it?
Leave her alone!
What is this?
What's it say?
Have you said something? It's addressed to me. Did you tell her my
name? No! What's it say?
Your granddad would have wanted you to have... it's a pity you're not more like... It won't do you any good, and oh, she's just rambling on. Oh, find the bag that's you. What does that even mean, find the bag that's me?
Mary, the theory that people will carry your bags. I would look for a flimsy one if I were you. Flimsy one.
But I don't know what that's supposed to... Oh, this is it? Oh, no, finally, I have it.
What's
it say? And it's ruined. It's worthless. She's completely ruined it. Mary Hart's Charlie. I'm done for it. You haven't seen your head.
Mary loves Charlie. Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
Where is he? I got your message. Where is he?
I should have known you wouldn't have got to. He's gone. But Mary's dead anyway.
Oh, Mary. Oh, Holly, I'm so sorry.
You know, she was the best thing that ever happened to me, Sue.
She was one off, one in a million. They'll never make anyone like her again.
She would have hated it off, Sue. I think she's glad to be dead.
Well, I'll tell you, she wouldn't have to tell you off getting her coat all wet with those tears. I better get Mary sorted. Coffee later. Strong. Italian.
If you're behind.
Two sugars. Almost forgot. She gave me this letter to give to you.
What is it?
It's a private letter. She asked for you to read it.
Dear Ollie, yesterday I splashed out on an outfit in Oxfam and paid a little visit to a posh safe deposit firm. You'd have enjoyed the performance. Cost me 100 up front for rental, but I reckon I'll not need too much dosh from now on. There's a bit of dosh there for my funeral, not having a pauper's one. Keys in this envelope will get you into the box. I'm giving you the name of a mate of Charlie's who deals with private collectors, and you're on your own from there. Do something good for yourself. Stop pretending to be a flimsy. You can carry a hell of a lot more than you think, and don't let anyone tell you different. And if you're lucky enough to meet up with a strong Essien bag, don't muck about. Grab it with both hands. Now, bugger off and get on with living. And don't play that leading song at my funeral.
Today we saw hundreds attend the funeral of Mary Smith, affectionately known as the Bard of the South Bank. Mary was a familiar figure, and she drew in many tourists when she recited all 34 verses of Browning's epic poem, Childe Roland to Dark Tower Cain. The local council have decided to honour her with a brass plate which is to be fixed to the bench she frequently used as bed. The mayor says that the proper
bar.